Hello friends, and welcome back to my channel Server Gyan. My name is Dr. Lokendra Singh. Within this video, we are going to explain about EC2 dashboard and the components which we are seeing here, like what all these are. If you are working in corporate environment, so you should be knowing about this. And if you are going to face interview, so these are quite required, because these are the particular components which are quite important for facing interview. You should be knowing what all does this mean. Fine. If you have not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe, like and share videos with your friends, as they can also get utilization, they can also get knowledge about it, about AWS cloud. Fine. So first of all, let us talk about instance. Instance means the number of servers which you have running in your environment, so you will be redirected to that page. Launch template means when you have pre-configured template which will be used to launch multiple instances. When you launch an instance, you have to configure multiple steps. You have to go through multiple steps, like selecting AMI, means Amazon Machine Image. And AMI is a pre-configured software template of your operating system, which contains some users, mount points, some installed software, and rest of it, stuff it contains. Fine. Okay, then spot instances means this comes under purchasing option. AWS has multiple purchasing options. Either you can go for pay as you go model. It means if you are going to utilize your server for a couple of minutes, then you will have to pay for that only. And if you are going to pay your if you are going to utilize your server for 2 days only, so you will have to pay for 48 hours. Fine. So AWS charges for instance on hourly basis. There is one more trick. Let us say you are going to utilize your server for 1 hour, but you have rebooted that server 5 times. I will repeat this stuff again. If you are utilizing your server and you utilized your server for 1 hour only, but you have rebooted your machine 5 times within that hour, so you will have to pay for 6 hours, because AWS calculates every hour from your last reboot. So this is a trick here of AWS. Okay, then if we talk about reserved instances means if you have an agreement with AWS that at least for a year you will definitely utilize this server, so these are known as AWS reserved instances. Now what are dedicated hosts? If you want to have your own servers inside AWS, then you can ask AWS to allow you to have some dedicated host. It means by default AWS allows you to create resources on shared hardware, but if you want to have your separate hardware to create your own resources, so you can utilize this particular dedicated host. But make sure if you're going to utilize your dedicated host, so at least for 1 year you will have to make an agreement with AWS. Fine. Now what is this AMI? AMI, it means Amazon Machine Image, once again, as we have already discussed about. So this is a software template of your operating system, which contains predefined software, mount points, and rest of the stuff. Okay, then let's talk about volumes. Volume means hard disk drive, which we allocate to our servers for storing data and taking backup and rest of the stuff. Okay, then what is the snapshot? If we have running machine within our account, or we have some additional hard disk drive created, so we can take backup of all these, whether of running instance or of our volumes. So these are known as snapshot. What is security group? Security group means when you are going to create an EC2 instance, so at least one security group has to be there. You cannot create your EC2 machine without creating EC2 group. Okay, now what is elastic IP address? AWS provides you three type of IP addresses. One is public, second is private, and third one is elastic IP address. Guys, understand this thing. Elastic IP is also known as public IP, but there is only one difference between both. Elastic IP has capability to be reallocated or reassigned to same instance. Let us say I created one machine and I have hosted web server on that. So I would need that definitely this IP which is currently configured on that machine, so that has to be reallocated as and when I reboot my server. By default, if you reboot your server, so AWS does not guarantee, does not share, does not acknowledge that you will get the same IP address as which was allocated to your machine earlier. But if you want to ensure that stuff, so you can utilize elastic IP addresses. Now what is placement group? As we already have discussed, that if you want that all of your machines should be configured or should be created on same physical host, so placement group is the option for that. But make sure one thing, that if you are going to create any placement group, so all machine types should be same. For example, if you are going to create some instances which are known as memory optimized or maybe compute optimized or maybe IO intensive, it means you want all instances to be in same placement group, should be of same type. You cannot have memory optimized and compute optimized instances in single placement group. Okay, then key pairs. Key pairs means when you create an instance, so you need to log into your machine as well. So when you log into your machine, so key pairs are required. Key pairs means SSH key pair you can think of. So private key pair will be downloaded at your desktop and public key pair will be presented at your EC2 instance. Fine. Now what is network interface? When you create any machine, so one network interface is associated with that. So then after, let's talk about load balancer. Load balancer means this is software configuration which is used to manage your load among your servers. For example, if you have a domain running www.example.com and you have four web servers configured behind that, so load balancers are used to distribute traffic among your servers. Fine. Target group. Target group means logical boundary of those servers which are running as your instances. So I can create somewhere 200 target groups within my account. Fine. Then after, these are some different configurations, so we will discuss later on, but for now we are going to initiate with creating EC2 instances. Fine. So let us create one instance. So there are two tabs, one is this and second one is this, so you can use either of to create your instance. So let us begin with instance creation. I'm going to create this instance very soon, within a while only, but if you want to go for deep dive, so keep on watching my videos. I'm going to explain each component of this EC2 machine creation within very detail. So first of all, let us select AMI. I have selected Amazon AMI. With the next video, you will get to know that what all things you need to keep in mind before selecting AMI. So this is instance type, instance image, instance template, whatever hardware you are going to use, you can use here. We will discuss in detail in next videos. Then after, you will have to configure like how many instances you want to configure. This is purchasing option. You want to have spot instances. I'm not going to select this one for now. This is VPC. It means I'm going to have default VPC now. These are the stuffs which we will discuss in upcoming videos. Then subnets. These are some data centers available in AWS. I'm going to select anyone we can select. Autos in public IP, obviously if I need to log into this machine, so I will need to have one public IP assigned on this server. IAM role, we need not to worry about this for now, we will discuss later on. Then after, termination shutdown behavior, it means what should happen if you stop this machine, should this get terminated or you want to reboot this machine again. For your production server, only this option should be selected, and one more check should be there that if you stop your machine or if you terminate your machine, that should not be accidentally terminated. Fine. So this is option used for protection against accidental termination. Then after monitoring, by default Amazon provides detailed monitoring and default monitoring. Default monitoring span is 5 minutes. It means all of your resources will be monitored every 5 minutes. You will get a notification after 5 minutes only. But if you want to go for detailed monitoring, then you can utilize this option where you will be notified within a span of 1 minute, but this is chargeable. You will have to pay some additional charges. Tenancy, it means where you want to run your instance. You want to run a dedicated instance, it means that instance which you purchased, that you had an agreement with AWS that you will be utilizing that instance at least for a year. You want to have an instance on shared hardware, or you have some dedicated host where you want to launch your instances. Fine. So I'm going to have shared instance. Okay, T2 Micro Unlimited, this is a new feature of AWS. We will discuss later on in upcoming videos. Okay, then after, we are going to go for adding a storage. This is root disk type. Device name will be XVDA. Size is 8 GB. Hard disk type, there are three type of disk available. General purpose, provision IPS and magnetic. So I'm going to select general purpose SSD. Next, add tags. So for adding tags, I'm going to select, let us, I'm going to give name here, and this is for AWS test. Fine. This is the option if you want to apply the same tags to that instance and volume as well. So you can click on both. You can check these boxes. Then security. By default, one security group is configured here, where port 22 is allowed. Fine. So if you want to allow this port 22 from anywhere, so you can click anywhere. There are three options. Custom, it means you can define your own CIDR. If you know about your company and its IP address is being used for connectivity and all, you can define that particular. Then, but I'm going to select here as anywhere. Fine. This is not suggested for production environment, guys. So please be aware that always use custom or my IP address, whatever is preferred for you. But for this practical, for this tutorial, I'm going to use anywhere. Then review all the components, whatever you have configured. You can check here that what security group you used, what was instance type you selected, the instance detail. If you want to check, you can check all the instance details, and after that you will launch it. Fine. But for launching this instance, at least you will have to have one key pair. There are three options. Choose an existing key pair. If you are going to create one another machine, so you can choose your existing key pair. But as I don't have any key pair here, so I'm going to give it a name, EC2-test. This will be name of my key pair until unless I download this key pair. So this particular launch instance section will not be available. Fine. So I'm going to download this key pair. As soon as my key pair will be downloaded, so my launch instance configuration tab will be highlighted. Fine. As this is being downloaded, as you can see here, and this is highlighted. So I have launched this instance under Singapore region. Make sure one thing, that you are, once you log out from your account, so your machine should be terminated. If you want to check your machine whether that is created or not, you will click on this section and you will be directed to your EC2 console. Fine. So what we are seeing here is that that machine is being, this is for AWS test, whatever name I gave there, I assigned. So this is the tag which has been replicated to this machine. This is instance ID, this is instance type, state is pending, status checks are initializing. So this is our EC2 machine created. Fine. So this is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you like, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Please keep on watching as I'll be discussing and describing all these options and what does this particular dashboard mean. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good time.